Hey, today I'm off the beaten path. I'm gonna explore some of Oregon's covered bridges. Stay tuned. Welcome back to Pine Meadows Hobby Farm. I'm your host, Jerry Hansen. This is the Off the Beaten Path series. I like to get off the homestead and go out and venture around my homestay and maybe some other places that I can get around to. In this episode, I'm gonna explore some of the covered bridges in Oregon. There's approximately 54 bridges, covered bridges around Oregon, but I'm gonna look at the shortest one, the longest one, the oldest one, and the newest one, and some of them in between, all off the beaten path. Now I'm choosing to start the show with this bridge because it's the newest bridge. This is the Weimer Bridge, located in the remote little town of Weimer, Oregon, in Jackson County. This bridge spans over the Evans Creek, and an earlier covered bridge span built in 1892 was located at this location. After the bridge deteriorated in 1927, local residents decided to refurbish it in 1962. However, by the mid-70s, the bridge was closed after further decline. Repairs in 1985 led to the opening or reopening of the 8-ton limit, later reduced to 3 tons before further repairs were undertaken. Unfortunately, in 2003, the structure collapsed into Evans Creek with a gentleman and his 2 grandkids on the bridge. Now this bridge you see behind me is the newest bridge in Oregon. It was constructed in 2008. With the help of some federal funds, local labor, the bridge was replaced with a look-alike using trusses reinforced with metal braces, laminated beams that look like timber, concrete approaches, and industrial roofing made to resemble wood shakes. The one-way bridge still is only 17 feet wide, as was the original, and has a load limit of now 10 tons. Traveling up the I-5 corridor, we're gonna go look at some other bridges on our map. Continuing our countdown from the newest bridge to the oldest bridge in Oregon, we're gonna move up the freeway to Cottage Grove, Oregon, where inside the city, the Chambers Covered Railroad Bridge was completely dismantled and rebuilt in 2010. This bridge spans the Coast Fork of the Willamette River in Cottage Grove. The original bridge was built in 1925 to carry rail traffic hauling logs from Lorraine Valley to the J.H. Chambers Mill, a lumber mill which was located in the area. Now the train used to go across there until the mill burnt down and then they shut the railroad bridge down. Then it fell into decay and they had to remove it and of course replace it in 2010. While we're here in Cottage Grove, Oregon, we'll go ahead and go downtown. There is a covered pedestrian bridge that spans the same river, the Coastal Fork of the Willamette River, which it's built along Main Street. This bridge measures 84 feet long, 10 feet wide, and 14 feet high. It was built in 1987, the 100th year since the founding of the city. Constructed mostly of volunteers, it was made from timber salvage from the Meadows and Birnbaum bridges, which were dismantled in 1979. Thank you. another pedestrian bridge that bears attention, and it is in downtown Canyonville, Oregon. The bridge was built in 1976. It's 75 feet long. It sits in their park, which sits along the little creek there. It's Canyon Creek Bridge. Now, in 1966, the Belknap Bridge, also known as the Mackenzie River Bridge, sits in Lane County. This bridge is well maintained, so it is open to traffic. As you can see, we can drive through the bridge right here. Down in Douglas County, we have the Milo Academy Bridge, which is actually the only privately owned bridge nearby. Built in 1962, has some interesting construction, with the Academy deeming that the original bridge was no longer safe for heavy farm equipment and vehicles. They needed to construct a new bridge, so they destructed the original bridge and built this new steel bridge, which lacked a covering because it was not required to protect the steel truss structure from degradation. Due to public concern about losing part of their community identity, the covering from the original bridge was adapted to fit the new bridge. The 100-foot span of this bridge carries traffic over the Umpqua River. And then we come to the Dorena Bridge. It's a 105-foot structure which crosses the Roe River near the upper end of Dorena Reservoir. This bridge was built in 1949. The architecture is a Howe truss design. Now we travel up the road and come to one of my favorite bridges. It's this beautiful red bridge. This 180-foot long span crosses the Willamette River. It is a Howe truss design, and it is the only covered bridge west of the Mississippi River which has a separate pedestrian walkway. This bridge was built in 1944 after the previous two bridges were destroyed, one by flood and one by a severe storm. It was owned by the West Fir Lumber Company to carry logging trucks and lumber trucks to the company lumber mill and the mill pond, which sat right across the river. Down the road from there is the Lowell Bridge, built in 1874. This bridge is built on the reservoir. The bridge opened in 1945, and it boasts as the widest bridge in Oregon. This covered bridge is a Howe truss construction, and it also serves as a museum inside the bridge for all the covered bridges within Lane County.
Back down the road in Douglas County, we come to the Cabot Creek Bridge. It was opened in 1943 in its present location. It was built with Tudor portal arches allowing room for log trucks to go through. The bridge was part of a thematic nomination of the Oregon's Covered Bridges in 1979, but Douglas County blocked the listing. The Cabot Creek Bridge crosses the Little River up by Glide, Oregon. Nearby in the same county, we come to the Neil Lane Bridge. The Neil Lane Bridge spans the South Myrtle Creek outside of Myrtle Creek, Oregon. Its load limit right now is 5 tons, and it was constructed in 1929. Some say it was constructed in 1939. At 42 feet, it is also considered one of the shortest covered bridges in the state, but we're saving that distinction for our final and oldest bridge in the state. Other notable features include plank flooring, arch portals, and narrow window openings, as well as a metal floor. The structure has a 5-ton weight limit. Then we go into the town of Jasper, Oregon, to visit the Pengrub Bridge, opened for traffic in 1938 to honor Byron J. Pengra, a government surveyor. The bridge was listed in the National Register of Historic Places in 1979. An interesting feature of this bridge is that the lower cords of the bridge at 16 by 18 inches by 126 feet are among the longest timbers ever used in an Oregon bridge. Timbers of this size simplified some aspects of construction but required special techniques to finish and position at the site. Other features of the bridge include ribbon windows under the eaves, a side window in one side, and semi-elliptical portals. Then my wife and I visited what I thought was one of the prettier bridges, is the Good Pastor Bridge that spans the McKenzie River near the community of Vida in Lane County, Oregon. The bridge's length is 237 feet and 17.7 feet wide, and it has a height of 13.3 feet. It was built in 1938. In the same area, Marcola, Oregon, the Ernst Bridge, which was built in 1938, it is of a Howe Truss design. Back over in Lowell, Oregon, we see the Unity Bridge. Constructed in 1936, it is a Howe Truss design also. Now we're getting older bridges. In 1933, the Rochester Covered Bridge opened up for traffic. It's located in Douglas County. The bridge design is unique among Oregon's housed structures, which includes side windows with curved tops. The bridge has 4 windows on each side, portals with flat arched openings, and exposed false beams at the gabled ends. Near Walden, Oregon, the Stewart Bridge is of a Howe Truss design also, and it was built in 1930. This bridge is 60 feet long. It spans the Roe River. Thank you. Built in 1930, the Horse Creek Bridge, which is also known as the McKenzie Bridge, it now sits in a park in Myrtle Creek, Oregon. It spans Horse Creek at a length of 105 feet long. Near the city of Cottage Grove again, we have the Kieran Bridge, which was constructed in 1925. This bridge spans the Roe River at 105 feet long. It's open only to pedestrians at this time. The Antelope Creek Bridge is a wooden covered bridge, 58 feet long, spanning the Little Ute Creek in Eagle Point, Oregon. This bridge was originally built in 1922 over Antelope Creek, but has since then been moved and reconstructed on its new location over Little Ute Creek. The bridge was relocated in 1987 and reassembled, and also is now on the National Registries of Historic Covered Bridges in Oregon. Once it was relocated here, it no longer served automobile traffic. It now becomes foot traffic for people to get on either side of the town of Eagle Point in the center of where this bridge sits. Notable features of this bridge include its queen post truss, modified by addition of a king post, its ribbon openings under the eaves, and its cantilevered buttresses. The bridge has a cedar roof, semicircular portals, and board siding without battens. Near the little town of Remote in southwestern Oregon, Coos County's only covered bridge is the Sandy Creek Bridge, yes, which spans Sandy Creek. This bridge was built in 1921 and is also of a Howe truss design. Near the small community of Dexter in Lane County sits Parvin Bridge, built in 1921. It is of a Howe truss design. It spans Lost Creek at 75 feet long. Also in Lane County, we have the Mosby Creek Bridge, which was built in 1920. It's 90 feet long, 13 and a half feet wide, and 12.3 feet tall. And of course, this bridge spans Mosby Creek. In 1920, the Grave Creek Bridge opened for traffic. It is the only covered bridge viewable from the I-5 freeway near the town of Merlin. It is 105 feet long of a Howe truss design with Gothic windows on each side as well as rounded portals and a shake roof. Then at the end of the Oregon Trail, which branched off into the Applegate Trail, sits the McKee Bridge. This bridge, at 45 feet long, spans over the Applegate River in the community of Applegate Bridge. Then we come to the Pass Creek Bridge. It is a covered bridge which sits in the city of Drain in that spans Pass Creek. At 61 feet long, built in 1906, the Pass Creek Bridge, which spans Pass Creek, is of a Howe design also. It has no windows, although it had cedar siding and some hand-hewed timbers. This is for pedestrian traffic only, as it sits in the park and near their civic center in downtown Drain, Oregon. And then we move to the oldest bridge and the shortest bridge. Now that we've come to the end of our journey, this is the final bridge on our episode of the journey that going off the beaten path to discover some of the covered bridges in the state of Oregon. Now we began the series, or began the episode, with the newest covered bridge in Weimer, Oregon, in western Jackson County. Now we're in eastern Jackson County, back in Jackson County, in Lake Creek, Oregon. Outside of Lake Creek sits the oldest bridge in Oregon. Now not only is it the oldest bridge in Oregon, it is also the shortest bridge in Oregon. Now, early accounts state that this bridge was built in 1878. But according to records, it may have a much later history. And the placard up here is 1881, but notice it says built about 1881. The 1878 anecdotal account was that just that, anecdotal. They couldn't prove it, they couldn't verify it, nor they could not disprove it. So they put a date on it, 1881 about. The bridge was placed on the National Historic Registries in 1979, at which point they closed it to auto traffic, and they constructed this bypass bridge next to the historic bridge to carry the load. The truss of the bridge is a queen post style modified by cross members. Other features include open ends rather than the usual portal arches, ribbon openings at the eaves, and buttresses that are cantilevered. The bridge has a shingle roof and a floor of diagonal planking. Local residents installed a new roof in 1985. Well, that completes this journey of off the beaten path. And boy, some of these bridges are truly located off the beaten path. Stay tuned to more videos. You can do that by subscribing and clicking that bell icon. That alerts you to new videos as I do upload them. Hey, give us a thumbs up. Click that share button. Sharing our videos on your social media platforms helps us out greatly. And if you'd be so kind, check out the links down below. If you're watching this on a PC, I have a store down there, and I offer some merchandise. Yes, that's right, I have merch. You have a thermal bottle, you have a hot coffee mug, and then you have a regular coffee mug. All have the Pine Meadows Hobby Farm logo on one side, and my Duck in a Cup Productions on the opposite side. Please leave a comment, be safe, always be kind. We'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye now.